Morning, students. Till now we studied the acid coupled amplifiers. Today we will discuss the direct coupled amplifiers and transformer coupled amplifiers. According to the interconnection of amplifier and load, we are dividing into three types. According to the interconnection of amplifier and load, amplifiers are divided into three types. That means how the load is connected to the amplifier. Based on that, we are divided into three types. One is RC coupled amplifier. Second one is direct coupled, and third one is transformer coupled. Yes, in the RC coupled amplifier, the amplifier is connected to the load through the capacitor, like this. Yes, so the amplifier is connected to the load through the capacitor. Yes, till now we analyzed this type of RC coupled amplifiers. Direct coupled means amplifier is directly connected to the load. We are not using any component in between the amplifier and load. Yes, this is direct coupled. Next one, transformer coupled. Here, amplifier is connected to the load through the amplifier. Here amplifier is connected to the load through the transformer. Yes. So now it is connected to the load RL. So here the transform ratio is N1 to N2. This is input. This one is output. Yes. N1 is to N2. Yes. So now in this, load is connected to the amplifier through the capacitor. Here load is directly connected to the amplifier to the load, so it is direct coupled. Here load is connected to the transformer, then it is amplifier. So a transformer is used to interconnect the amplifier and load, so it is called transformer coupled. This is direct coupled, this is RC coupled. Till now we studied the RC coupled amplifier. Yes, now we'll see the direct coupled amplifier. Direct coupled amplifier is an amplifier in which load is directly connected to the amplifier. In which load is directly connected to the amplifier. Such amplifier is called direct coupled amplifier. Direct coupled amplifier. Yes. It is also an amplifier in which load is directly connected to the amplifier. Such amplifier is called direct coupled amplifier. So you know the direct coupled amplifier is like this. This is amplifier. Their output is taken across the load. Yes. So for this amplifier, we will get the frequency response like this. So it is F equals to 0. Yes. Here it does not have any large capacitors. Why? Because we are not using any capacitor to interconnect the amplifier and load. Yes. Therefore, voltage gain does not reduce at the low frequencies. So here we are not getting these kind of. Yes. Here you will get. Yes. So in RC coupled, you will get this kind of frequency response. Here you will not get any gain decreases at the low frequency. Why? Because it does not have any large capacitors. So we can write, it does not have any large capacitors. Therefore, voltage gain does not reduce at low frequencies. Yes. So we don't have any gain reduction or gain decreases at low frequencies. Yes. But here, voltage gain is decreases at higher frequencies. Voltage gain decreases at high frequency because of internal capacitance, high frequencies due to junction capacitance or internal capacitance, junction capacitance of BJT. Yes, so you cannot remove the junction capacitance. So here you will get the voltage gain decreases at high frequencies because of the junction capacitance. Yes, this direct coupled amplifier is low pass circuit. Yes, it is looking like your low pass filter frequency response. Yes, RC coupled is looking like your band pass. That means certain band of frequencies gain will be high. Here, for the lower frequencies, gain is high. That means it is acting as a low pass circuit. Yes, so we can write this direct coupled amplifier is low pass circuit and RC coupled is band pass circuit. Yes or no? From the frequency response of direct coupled, we can say it is looking like low pass filter. So at 3 bit below the 3 dB frequencies, it has the maximum gain. That means it allows the other frequencies. Yes, so it can, we can say it is low pass filter. Coming to here, we can say some particular band of frequencies allows the maximum gain. So it is a band pass filter. Yes, so we said this RC coupled amplifier is not designed on IC because of the larger capacitance. But here, all IC amplifiers are direct coupled amplifiers only. So from this we can say this direct coupled amplifier is fabricated on ICs. Yes. So what are the advantages of this direct coupled amplifier? The main advantage is we can fabricate this amplifier, direct coupled amplifier, on silicon chip. That means whatever the IC amplifiers are available in market, most of the IC amplifiers are direct coupled only. Why? Because here we don't have the large capacitance values. Yes, when there is no large capacitance, then silicon chip area is very less. Yes, and it can amplify the DC signal also. Yes, so advantages are one is it is ideal for fabrication on IC. Second one, it can amplify DC also. It can amplify DC signal also. Yes. Next, you will see the disadvantages and applications of direct coupled amplifiers. Yes. First, we will see the disadvantages. Yes. First one, here maximum power cannot be transferred to the load due to the impedance mismatch. Same. Maximum power cannot be transferred to the load due to impedance mismatch. Yes, here R0 is not equals to R. Yes or no? Same as our RC coupled amplifiers. And no DC isolation between the amplifier and load. Here, no DC isolation between amplifier and load. Why? Because here we are not using the capacitor in between the load and amplifier. So, which can cause disturbance? Which can cause disturbance in operating point? In operating point. Yes, these are the disadvantages of direct coupled amplifiers. Applications. It is used as DC amplifier and very low frequency amplifiers. Why? Because at low frequencies, your gain is non-decreases. So, it is used as DC amplifier and very low frequency signals amplifier. Very low frequency amplifier. Yes. So that means it can amplify the frequency signals of 1 hertz, 2 hertz, 3 hertz, like this. As examples. So why? Because at lower frequencies, here the gain is not decreases. Yes, because there is no large capacitance. So here it is used to amplify the DC signals and very low frequency signals like 1 hertz, 2 hertz, 3 hertz. Yes. Next, we'll see the transformer coupled amplifier. We know generally this transformer is used to impedance matching. Yes. So here maximum power is not transferred. We are not getting the maximum power transfer in the both the amplifiers. That means RC coupled and direct coupled. To achieve that maximum power transfer, we are using the transformer coupled amplifiers. Here you can say a transformer is used to interconnect the amplifier and load. Amplifier and load. So you can see the this is amplifier and this one is transformer and this one is primary winding of the transformer, secondary winding of the transformer, and secondary winding of transformer is connected to the load. Yes, this is RL. So now it is N1 and 2. Yes, so here load is connected to the amplifier through the transformer. Yes, so here you will get the frequency response like this. Here this is the frequency response of transformer coupled amplifier. Here you will get the sudden peak here in the frequency response. A sudden peak appears in the frequency response at high frequencies due to the parallel resonance caused by the leakage elements of the transformer. Yes, so a sudden peak appears in frequency response at high frequencies due to parallel resonance caused by leakage elements of transformer. Yes. So here you get the maximum power transfer. Yes. So the advantage of this transfer coupled amplifier is mainly maximum power transfer. So maximum power transfer is achieved in the amplifier to load because of transformer is an impedance matching. Yes. So when I am using the transformer in between the two circuits, the transformer is used for the impedance matching one. The main application of transformer in this circuit is to provide the impedance matching. Yes. So the maximum power can be transferred to the load because of the transformer is present in the circuit. Yes or no? Yes. So we can get advantages. Yes. So maximum power can be transferred. Maximum power can be transferred to load. Because transformer present. Transformer is an impedance matching. Transformer is an impedance matching element. As for the maximum power transfer, for maximum power transfer, reflected load should be equal to the output resistance of amplifier as we must have the that load resistance must be equal to the output of the amplifier as so here maximum power transfer is achieved in this transfer coupled amplifier because of the transformer is present which is acting as a impedance matching element. As for the maximum power transfer condition here reflected load should be we are connecting the transformer in between the amplifier and load, that load is reflected from the primary side. As that reflected load should be equal to the output resistance. That means condition for this is you can write R dash L is equal to the R naught. As R dash L is the reflected load, which is seen from primary side, primary side of the transformer. S and RL is the effective load. S and R naught is output resistance of amplifier. To achieve the maximum power transfer in the transformer coupled amplifier, we must maintain the reflected load is equal to the output impedance of or output resistance of transformer, amplifier. As so here I am drawing amplifier, this is N1 and N2. Yes, so R dash L is nothing but here it is R dash L. Yes, and this is RL. Yes, so we are taking here output. So to get the maximum power transfer to the load in the transfer coupled amplifier, we must equate the reflected load, should be equal to the output resistance of the amplifier. Yes, so we can write this reflected load R dash L equals to N1 by N2 whole square into RL. Otherwise, I am writing N1 by N2 is the, I am writing as N square into R. Yes, when this N square into RL is equal to the R naught, then you will get the maximum power. So, from this we can write N square equals to R naught by RL. So, from this we can write N equals to under root of R naught by RL. So N is nothing but N1 by N2 equals to under root of R naught by RL. So from this we can choose the translation. Yes, so R dash L is nothing but reflected load which is seen by the from the primary. Yes, this is R dash L. Yes, so why I am writing this R dash L equals to N1 by N2 into RL? Because we already know from the basics V1 by V2 equals to N1 by N2 translation. Similarly, I2 by I1 equals to N1 by N2. Yes, sir. Yes, from this we can write V1 equals to N1 by L2 into V2. And from this we can write I1 equals to N2 by N1 into I2. Yes, by writing V1 by I1. So here we are having V1, here we are having the I1. From writing V1 by I1, you will get N1 by N2 whole square into V2 by I2. Yes, so V1 by I1 is nothing but reflected resistance, reflected load R dash L. So N1 by N2 whole square, V2 by I2 is nothing but RL, load at the secondary winding. As from this I have written R dash L equals to N1 by N2 whole square into R. Yes, so to maintain the reflected load resistance is equals to the output resistance of the amplifier, we can choose the, based on that we can choose the turns ratio. Yes, so this perfect DC isolation between the amplifier and load. So in this way we can achieve the maximum power transfer in the transformer coupled amplifiers. Yes, so next advantage is perfect DC isolation is present. Perfect DC isolation between amplifier and load. Why? Because here we are having the transformer. Because of the transformer, it will provide the DC isolation. Yes, sir. Next, we can say higher efficiency because primary winding does not dissipate the DC power. So it will provide the higher efficiency because primary winding does not dissipate the DC power. Yes. And next advantage is higher voltage gain than RC coupled amplifier. Yes or no? Yes, why? Because the maximum power is transferred. When the statement is true, higher voltage gain is achieved than RC coupled amplifier if turns ratio is greater than 2. Turns ratio N is greater than 2. Yes. So, voltage gain of transformer is AV of transformer coupled amplifier is, you can say, relationship between the voltage gain of transformer coupled and RC coupled. So, AV of the voltage gain of transformer coupled amplifier is, transformer coupled amplifier is, you can say, N by 2 times of RC coupled. Yeah. Voltage gain of RC coupled amplifier. Yes. So, that voltage gain of transformer coupled amplifier is equal to the N by 2 times of RC coupled amplifier voltage gain. Yes. What are the disadvantages here? Disadvantages are here it has the poor frequency response. So, it provides poor frequency response. Why it is provide poor frequency response? Because of the leakage elements. Yes, in frequency response itself we are having the some sudden peak. Yes, so it provides the poor frequency response. Yes, here we can say low frequency signals are also less amplified. Yes, and these transformer coupled amplifiers will provide the more noise. Yes, it provides more noise because of the transformer. Yes, and we can say the cost of transformer is more, cost and size of transformer is also more. Cost and trans- constant size of transformer is more as applications. Now applications are mainly here we are using the transformer to get the maximum power. Yes. So transformer coupling is used to transformer coupled is used in the power amplifiers. Why? Because it is used as impedance matching. So it is used in power amplifiers. Yes. This is about the transformer coupled amplifier. Yes. Thank you.